In previous lectures, we've talked about the multiplication rule, and we used it to find a formula for the number of permutations of a set. Now, in this lecture, we're going to look at the question of finding a formula for the number of combinations of a set. We're actually going to walk through the process for deriving the formula, which is going to make this really the most challenging lecture in our introductory combinatorics series. So don't be concerned if you don't understand this the first time through, all right? You may need to review it a few times before you get all of the steps, before you really see where they're coming from. And ultimately, the key thing that you need to take away is the formula that we end up with at the end of the procedure on the very last screen. Now, to see where the formula comes from, I'm going to start with a specific example, okay? Suppose that we have four people. We want to know how many groups or combinations of the three people we can make. Well, if we let the people be A, B, C, and D, you can think of that as Adam, Bruce, Charles, and Diane, if you like. It's just easier if we write out just the first initials of their name. Then the list of all the permutations is what you see on this slide. Now, because the list covers the permutations, it's got too many entries for the number of combinations. And let me point out why here. Let's see if I get my pen going. There we go. For example, ABC and CAB both represent the same combination. The order of the letters may be different, but both heads have just the letters A, B, and C, which means that they both represent the same combination. Now, to see how many duplicates we have, I'm going to take my list and rearrange it so that all of the sets that represent the same combination, that is, that have the same letters, even if the order is different, are on the same row. Okay, so now the first row has all the combinations of the letters A, B, and C. The second row has all the combinations of the letters A, B, and D, and so on down the rows here. Now, the key thing you should notice is that 3 is the size of each set in our list, okay? So remember that if you look at the entire table, it has all the permutations of a set of 4 elements into groups of 3. All right, so with this information, we can calculate the number of combinations. All right, here's how we're going to do it. First, the number of entries in the table is equal to the number of rows times the number of columns. All right, that's just, you know, elementary arithmetic. Now, the number of entries in the table is equal to the number of 3 permutations. That's the total number of permutations of 4 elements into a group of 3. The number of rows is equal to the number of 3 combinations. That's this value here. And the number of columns is equal to the number of permutations of a set with 3 elements. All right, then I'm going to do a little arithmetic. I'm just going to, or a little algebra. I'm just going to rearrange this a little bit. I'm going to divide both sides by permutations of a set with 3 elements. So I'm going to solve this for the number of 3 combinations, which is what we're looking to find a formula for here. Now, I'm going to need a little more room. So I just copied those calculations from the end of the last screen up to here. Okay, and now I'm going to replace the expressions on the right-hand side, the number of permutations, and the permutations of a set with 3 elements, with the formulas that we derived previously. Okay, the number of permutations is 4 factorial divided by 4 minus 3 factorial. That's the number of permutations of a set with 4 elements, where we're taking them 3 at a time. And the number of permutations of a set with 3 elements is just 3 factorial. All right, Now, that gives me this line here. Now, I'm just going to do a little simplification here, just a little basic fraction manipulation on the right-hand side. This is equal to this expression, all right? I just simplified the fractions here. Now, here's where we're ready to make the jump to the general formula, all right? To get a formula that works for a combination of R elements instead of the three in our example, from a set with N elements instead of the four in our example, I'm going to replace the fours in our formula with N, and I'm going to replace the threes in our formula with R. And that's going to give me a formula. That's going to give me the formula that I'm looking for. The number of R combinations of a set with N elements is equal to N factorial divided by R factorial times N minus R factorial. Okay, so here we have that written out all formally, right? And down here at the bottom, we've got a little notation. We will write the number of combinations as NCR, or sometimes we'll put one of them on top of each other. Okay, and as I said back at the beginning of the lecture, the key thing you need to take away, and you'll see this if you go on to look at the slides with examples, the key thing that you need to take away is this formula right here. All right, that combined with the formula for a permutation, for permutations that we saw on previous slides, these are the two fundamental formulas that are really at the core of combinatorics counting methods.